Good morning, students. Welcome back again in computer class. I hope you all are fine and healthy. So let's continue the chapter number 6, that is computer software. The topic is variety of software. So software is available in a variety of forms. So first one is package software. So it is a copyright software that is available in computer, retail store or on the internet. Next is custom software. So if you want a particular software as per your need, your requirement, then you may ask programmer to develop and design custom software for you. Next is web application. So it is a website that allow user to access software from any computer that is connected to the internet. Types of web application includes like email, word processing, that is a Google Docs, etc. Next is mobile application. So everybody familiar with this software. So mobile application, in short app, is an application you download from the app store of a mobile device or other location on the internet for a smartphone or other mobile device. Next is open source. So you can use and do modification on an open source software. It can usually be downloaded from the internet free of cost. Next is shareware. It is a copyrighted software that is distributed free of cost for a trial period. That means you have to make payment to the program developer if you want to use the program after the trial period end. Next is freeware. It is a copyrighted software provided at no extra cost by an individual or a company that retains all right to the software. So these are the some variety of software. Next is system software. So it is designed to control or maintain the operation of computer and its devices. So system software is characterized into operating system, device driver and utility program. So first is operating system. So operating system, in short we also call it as a OS, is a software that enable a computer system to work. And this is the first software to be loaded into a computer. It is a bridge between the user and the computer hardware. User like we people, and computer hardware means like a keyboard, mouse. The operating system recognizes input from an input devices. Operating system recognizes an input from input devices such as keyboard, mouse, microphone, PC, camera, and coordinates the display the output on the monitor, that means output devices. And when to print information, the manages data and instruction in memory and information stored on hard disk, that is also storage devices. And the operating system resides in the hard disk of computer. So we can say that so many functions performed by operating system. So there are many different operating systems which are designed for all different types of computers, and many of them have similar functions which are as follow. Just like first function, that is a booting. Each time you start your computer, listen carefully. Each time you start your computer, the computer loads the operating system from hard disk into the computer memory so that it can be used. This process is called booting. Generally we can say that start and restart, we call it as a booting. But actually what is that? Each time you start your computer, that time computer loads operating system from hard disk into the computer memory. We call it as a booting. Next function that is performed by operating system, that is the operating system let you give commands to the system. That means if you want to delete something, delete a document, move a file from one folder to another, these all commands given by operating system to your system. Next is you use the operating system to tell the computer to run an application software. Next, the operating system act as an interface or link between the user and the computer hardware. So generally, or in short, we can say that each and every function performed by one and only operating system. Now some categories of operating systems. First is standalone operating system, second server operating system, and third is mobile operating system. Standalone operating system that work on desktop computer, notebook computer, or a mobile computer device is also called a standalone operating system. So some standalone operating system are also called client operating system. Or some examples of standalone operating systems are Microsoft Windows, Mac operating system X, and Linux. So Microsoft Windows is a very popular operating system which is widely used nowadays. I think in the mid 1980s, Microsoft developed its first version of Windows which provides the graphical user interface, that is GUI. In this version, most of the information was represented in a pictorial form. Next is Mac operating system. So Mac operating system, actually Apple's first Macintosh computer, was released in 1984, and it's a user-friendly approach. Macintosh operating system has a set of high standard for operating system, and it is a multitasking operating system also. Next is Linux. So Linux is a popular free multitasking operating system. I again use a multitasking word. Actually, multitasking operating system allow a single user to work on two or more application that reside in memory at the same time. We call it as a multitasking system. So Linux is a popular free multitasking operating system in addition to the basic operating system, and the Linux is also include many free software and utility programs. Linux is an open source software, which means its a code is available free to the public for use, modification, and redistribution also. Next is server operating system. Actually, a server operating system is an operating system that is designed specially to support a network. Network means when two or more computers are connected, we call it as a network. So a server operating system typically resides in a server. The client computer on a network relay on the servers for resources. So some examples of server operating system includes like a Windows Server, OS X Server, Unix, and Linux. So Windows Server means developed by Microsoft. Windows Server enable organization to manage applications and websites on site. That means it can manage the applications and also it. Next is OS X Server developed by Apple, Windows Server developed by Microsoft, and OS X Server developed by Apple. So OS X Server enable organization to collaborate, share files, host websites and mail servers. Next is Unix. So capable of handling high volume of transactions in a multi-user environment. So multi-user environment means operating system enable two or more user to run a program simultaneously. We call it as a multi-user program. So Unix can handle high volume of transaction in a multi-user environment and working with multiple processor. Next is Linux. So Linux is often used on web server or on supercomputer because it provides a secure, stable, multi-user environment, and the Bharat operating system solution, in short we call it as a BOSS, B-O-S-S, is an easy to use version of Linux. So in short, Windows Server developed by Microsoft, and it enable organization to manage application and websites. OS X Server developed by Apple, and it enable organization to share files, host website and mail servers. Next is Unix, capable of handling high volume of transactions in a multi-user environment. And Linux, it's often used on a web servers or on supercomputers because it's provide a secure, stable, multi-user environment. So rest part I will explain in my next video. Thank you.